Hello to you all. Now today we're going to look at one of the largest structures in the brain, one that takes up a large percentage of the volume of the cerebrum. This is the corona radiata, an internal capsule. Now you'll instantly see that I've referred to the two elements as a single structure. And this is because the internal capsule is, in effect, a continuation of the corona radiata, a topic we shall return to a little later on. So, what is this structure and what is its function? Well, we'll start by looking at the coronal section of the brain. From this section, you can hopefully see the difference between the grey matter, which are the cell bodies, and the white matter, myelinated axons. In the very centre of the brain lies the thalamus, a collection of sensory and motor nuclei. Either side of the thalamus, there is a region of white matter. This is the internal capsule, running between the thalamus and the lentiform nucleus. If you follow this structure upwards, you'll see that it radiates out to all parts of the cortex, looking a bit like a crown, the corona radiata. The corona radiata and internal capsule are both made up of afferent and efferent projection fibres that carry information to and from the cerebral cortex. And while it looks like it's just a mass of random fibres, it is actually highly organised, with very specific tracks projecting to or from selective cortical regions. Efferent fibres are mostly concerned with motor function, either directly as axons of upper motor neurons or indirectly via projections to the striatum of the basal nuclei. Motor neurons in the corticospinal, cortical bulbar, and cortical nuclear pathways project from the motor regions of the cortex, passing between the thalamus and the lentiform nucleus, and on to the crus cerebri. Afferent fibres mostly arise from the thalamus. Sensory fibres from the anterolateral tract and dorsal columns project to the ventropostolateral nucleus of the thalamus, or VPL. The thalamus also receives motor inputs from the basal nuclei and the cerebellum via the ventrolateral nucleus, or VL, while visual and auditory fibres project to the geniculate nuclei, part of the metathalamus. Now there are other videos that explain these tracts, so if you want to know more about them, then please watch them as well. The thalamus is a major processing centre buried in the middle of the brain, and fibres from this structure project to all parts of the cerebral cortex via the thalamic radiations. These fibres form much of the afferent component of the corona radiata and internal capsule. This can be seen most clearly if we look at a horizontal section through the brain. If we look at this image, you can hopefully see that the internal capsule is bent in the middle to form two limbs, the anterior and posterior limbs. The bend in the middle is known as the genu, or knee. Fibres passing through the anterior limb project to the frontal lobe, while those passing through the posterior limb project principally to the occipital lobe, although also to the temporal and parietal lobes. Fibres projecting vertically pass to the somatosensory cortex as third-order sensory neurons and to the supplementary or premotor cortices, a part of the motor control systems. Projections from the geniculate nuclei form the optic and auditory radiations. So hopefully you can see that. While the white matter in the cerebrum looks like a jumble of fibres, in fact it's highly organised. Many fibres of the corona radiata and internal capsule are actually one and the same. And these two structures are really just a continuation of each other.